guys. All right, everybody stretch. Stretch up. Stretch the side. Oh, look at that, look at that. I just want to show you that you're able to stretch in worship. I dare you. I dare you to move out of your comfort zone. Go from wherever you have been. Kick it up a notch. It's all to Him. Like, worship is not about what people are seeing. It's awesome if they catch some fire off of you. That's great. But it is, the affection is going to one. That's God. So let's give Him our stretch this morning.
Our God is a lion, the Lion of Judah. He's roaring with power and fighting our battles. And every knee will bow before Him. Our God is a lamb, the lamb that was slain for the sin of the world. His blood breaks the chain. And every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. Every knee will bow before
it's coming on the cloud.
Who can stop the fire? Who can stop? Sing it again.
Sharing about worship. So I had a little picture revelation of, you know, we talk about the veil was torn, right? When Jesus was crucified, the veil was ripped in two. But the scripture that he read was about how we don't see through the veil anymore, that's now it's that we get to see him face to face. You following me? You with me? And I thought about the bride. A bride, when she walks down the aisle. I mean, nowadays, every bride doesn't wear a veil, but it used to be that every bride would wear a veil. She'd have the veil that covered her face, right? And she'd walk into the room, and the anticipation of what, I mean, when that bride walks in the room, it's like, oh my gosh, right? Coolest thing about when the bride walks in the room is she gets up here. Who moves the veil? Who moves the veil off the bride's face? The groom, Jesus. And he takes that veil off of us, the bride. And he says, oh no, I want to see you face to face. I don't want a thing blocking us. Nothing. Nothing. I want to see you. I want you to look in my eyes, and I'm going to look into your eyes. And I just want us, the bride, to look at him. You know, we're going to sing when you walk into the room, right? To him. But it's like so weird with my bride thing here. But just imagine that moment where the veil is off. Like right now, there is no veil that separates his face from your face. There's no veil He wants you to look full in his face. He wants you to see his fiery eyes, his passion, his how he wants you to see how he sees you. The beauty. Yeah. All right. Enough time.
The way you walk into the room, well, everything changes. Darkness has to tremble at the light that you bring. And when you walk into the room, everything starts burning. And nothing matters more than just to stay here at your feet and worship you.
Let's sing that verse again.
Fullness, we want you. Oh, come and consume God, all we are.
creation. Our hearts are yours. We want you. All the fullness of who we are. We want you. Yeah. Oh, come out and consume that. All we are. We give you permission. Our hearts are yours. We want you. Oh, sing it out to hell. Oh, come out and consume that. All we are. We, oh, we're yours. We're yours. My heart belongs to you alone. Oh, we want you. Oh, come out and consume that. All we are. We give you permission. Our hearts are yours. We want you. Oh, yeah. Sing it again. Come consume us. Oh, come out and consume that. All we
great way to just close out today. Psalm 100. Ready to just do something? Let's just, I'm going to read it and then we're going to do it. How's that? Is that right? Heard of that? Starts out, says this. Lift up a great shout of joy to the Lord. Then it says, hold on. Hey, this is the word, right? Lift up a great shout of joy to the Lord. Then he says, Go ahead and do it, everyone. Then it says in the stinks, nice angel's wings here just flopping. In Psalm 98, it says, it starts out, it says, go ahead and sing your brand new song to the Lord. Go ahead. So let's just, Sean, let's just hit a chord. Let's just hit a chord. Everyone, whatever word, whatever song, whatever picture he's given you, let's just take 30 seconds and sing that new song. Ready? One, two, three. As you serve him, be glad and worship him. Sing your way into his presence with joy. Realize that what this really means is that we have the privilege of worshiping the Lord our God. For he is our creator and we belong to him. We are the people of his pleasure. He has pleasure in us. And you can pass through his open gates with the password of praise. Continue. Come right into his presence with thanksgiving. Come bring your thank offering to him and affectionately bless his beautiful name. For the Lord is always good and ready to receive you. He's so loving and it will amaze you, so kind and it will astound you. And he is famous for his faithfulness towards you. Everyone knows our God can be trusted, for he keeps his promises to every single one of our kids. That is something to shout about this morning. Yeah, God. Bless you, God. In Jesus' name. Amen.